with another video. So this time the video is about some styling, some summer styling, a summer lookbook kind of a thing. Not exactly a lookbook, but I will be telling you guys about how you can style your clothes for every body type, because somebody recommended it to me on Instagram. If you're following me on Instagram, you'll know. If you're not, then what are you doing? Please go follow me on Instagram. My ID is in the description. So I got a suggestion for making a video on how to style your clothes for every body type. So I did my research in the notebook. I think there are four kind of type body shapes. There's a apple, there's pear, there's rectangle, and there's a hourglass. I think I only know of four. If there can be more, firstly, you shouldn't just go with what is written about how to style yourself. You can wear whatever you like, okay? If you want to wear it, do it. If you want to wear it, wear it. So yeah, I took some notes because I'm very dedicated, okay? So I took some notes and I have most of the clothes to show you for reference. Why do I have these clothes? I don't wear most of them, but I do. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So the first and foremost rule before starting the video is you should know what body type you have. I didn't know mine for a very, very long time, and I used to wear anything and then be like, okay, this doesn't look good on me, and then so yeah, firstly you should know what your body type is. There's apple, there's pear, they all sound blue, but they're all body types. Apple, pear, there's a rectangle, or you can call it boxy shape. I don't know. People say a lot of things. I don't know. People say a lot of mean things about people's body type. I don't like them. And obviously there's hourglass. So let me just tell you that there is no site that can help you with this. You'll have to figure out on your own what body type you are, and yeah, then follow the video and see what will suit you the best. Okay, so the first body type that we are going to talk about is the apple shape. See, so the apple shape is basically you are heavier on the top side and lighter on the bottom side, and your most of your weight is on the waistline. So the thing that you can flaunt, that you should flaunt, and you have them as your asset, are your legs and your neckline. You have amazing legs, you have amazing neckline. Good job. So tip number one for top, wear very flowy tops. Like for reference, I have it to show you, like this one. This one is so flowy. I love wearing it. Again, I'm telling you, every kind of clothes can be styled on any kind of body. This is my tip for everybody. Though I'm doing this video to tell you what can suit you the best, but as per me, if you ask me, I would just suggest whatever you like, just wear it. So this top, this is kind of flowy. A lot of flowy things, you should always wear tops with a little flow in it or something. I don't know what these are called, but I am calling it flowy top. Tip number two, wear 3/4 or full sleeve. Full sleeve and 3/4 just highlights your arms. They're good for you. So like this one, it's like a 3/4 kind of a thing. I don't know. I can't call it half. This is like 3/4. Tip number three, layer. Layer as much as you want. Wear 2 tops, 3 jackets, whatever you like. Like this jacket I have, I can layer this with a pink t-shirt. You can do too. Tip number four, crop tops are for you. Flowy crop tops are for you because it just defines your waistline, gives an illusion of a very thin waistline. Tip number five, wear straight cut pants. Straight cut pants, because it will make an illusion of longer legs, And also, if you really like patterns, go for bottoms which have patterns, polka dots, stripes, all kind of bottoms, just buy them. Pants, colorful patterns are your thing, just buy them. And if you really really like wearing bottoms with funky prints on it or something, just go simple on the top, just a plain white top with a polka dot just works fine. Tip number 6, if you're wearing stripes, wear vertical or diagonal stripes. Horizontal stripes are not for you. That is the tip I can give you. Stripes are usually on clothes to create illusion or something, but so for your body type, it's vertical or diagonal. Note, everybody, students, take note. So moving on to what not to wear. So what not to wear, number one is very very tight dresses. I don't think anybody likes wearing tight dresses. I feel very uncomfortable in them, so I don't wear them. Skinny jeans, don't wear skinny jeans. They just make your leg very very thick. And number 3, don't wear waist belts, like the one they wear here, don't wear them, because it's just gonna highlight your midsection, which has the weight as per the chart of the body type says. I don't know much about it, but whatever I know, I'm sharing it with you. So yeah, we're done with apple shaped body. Let's move on to the next. So moving on, we have the second body type, which is pear shaped. So for pear shaped body, you are heavier on the lower side and lighter on the upper side, so you need to balance that out. Your body shape is actually amazing because you have a shape of your own, plus you can create an illusion of an hourglass figure, which is amazing. I just find it so amazing. So my tip number 1 is wear wide legged bottoms, like not this one, like this one. You see, it just takes the weight, just creates an illusion that the weight isn't here much on the legs. Or an A-line skirt for bottom, you can definitely wear them so that they take the, they create an illusion of weight being divided from your lower body. But my tip number 2 is wear dresses which are A-line, like this one, because again, it just highlights your upper body and just flows on your lower side, so the weight isn't much visible. My tip number 3 to you is wear a lot of patterns on your top. A lot of patterns, ruffles, you can experiment with them. A plain bottom with a ruffle top looks great. So a ruffle top like this one looks great. My tip number 4 is wear A-line tops. Tops which are like this. You can definitely go for them. Looks amazing with wide leg pants or just straight pants. Just looks amazing. My tip number 5 to you is you can wear crop tops. Crop tops with high waist jeans looks amazing on your body type. It just creates an illusion of an hourglass figure. Like this one, the crop top. This is my favorite. Very, very, very favorite. So yeah, these were my tips for you. So now what not to wear. Don't wear skinny jeans. Skinny jeans just highlights weight in wrong places. So don't wear skinny jeans. And avoid wearing very loose tops, because your asset, your highlight is the upper body. Just don't hide it under oversized clothes. Why hide them? Just show it off like that. So yeah, this was for pear-shaped body. So we will move on to the next body type, which is rectangle. So your body is in proportion. The upper body, the lower body, and the waistline, they're all in proportion. It is kind of an hourglass minus the waistline. So for you, your arms and your legs are your asset. Just go out flaunting them, front them. So my tip number 1 for you is wear A-line skirts, like the one I showed. A-line skirts, it just highlights your legs and it clinches onto the waist, to create an illusion of an hourglass, which you just might have. I think we are being tricked. Everybody has two types of body type. We are being tricked into this illusion thing. Don't listen to them. Tip number two, wear a lot of ruffles on the collar and the sleeve. Don't wear it on the front part. Just looks very heavy. Like this one, this has ruffles here. So this is amazing. Tip number three, wear a lot of sleeveless, strappy clothes. They're meant for you. You have amazing shoulders. Just flaunt them. Like this one. How do I even show it to you? Like this one. I'll link everything down below so you can see where I bought them from. My tip number four for you is layered tops. So I don't have a layered top to show you. I have something like this to show you. The red one, you can see the layering. This just creates a lot of drama here. And to add more drama, my tip number five to you is wear long shrugs, coats and stuff. Just makes you look way taller than you are. Like this one. Tip number six is to wear dresses that flaunt your lower part of the body. Like you can wear a dress which is a little loose from the top but just goes on hugging the body from both the bottom. This is not exactly body hugging, but this does flaunt your body. So yeah, this one. My tip number seven for you is wear skinny jeans, not skinny jeans jeans, because it's summer, it's just gonna be very hot. So you can wear jeggings, what do we call jeggings, strappy tops, great. So now what not to wear. So avoid wearing fitted tops with loose bottoms. It just take away all the highlight of your body away from what we can see. Okay, so just don't. Unless you prefer it. If you prefer wearing tight t-shirt with baggy pants, just do it. Do it. Avoid wearing dresses which are too frilly. If they're not frilly, okay, then you can't see the legs. So yeah, don't wear very frilly frocks. I was gonna say frock dress. Because this is a frock, okay, I'm gonna call it frock. So now we move on to the next body shape, which is the hourglass figure. I have an hourglass figure, so I can tell you better about this. So I kept it for last. For an hourglass figure, you have a very well balanced upper and lower body, and your waistline is very defined. So basically, people who have hourglass figure can carry off anything. They can carry off anything. So I don't need to give you a lot of tips, but still I'm gonna give you some tips because I have to. So one, wear dresses that clinch to the waist, like this one. This is a dress which clinches to the waist and then flows. Ta-da! I just got it a few days back. So yeah, you should wear dresses that clinch to the waist and then flows. Looks beautiful. Same with tops. If you like flowy tops, just wear ones which clinch to the waist, are tight on the upper side and then flow. My tip number two to you is wear V-neck or plunge neck. Plunge neck is what they call. I don't know whatever it's called. It looks just beautiful and gives definition to your upper body. So tip number three is wear waist belts. It just defines your waistline. The thing to show off is your waistline, so you can wear a belt. My tip number four is you can wear a lot of A-line skater dresses or similar cut dresses. They look beautiful, defines your waistline, give definition to your legs, your arms, everything. Tip number five is they say you should wear body hugging dresses, but that totally depends on your preference. Like I don't wear body hugging dresses. I just don't feel comfortable. So I wear dresses which are tighter on the upper side and then flow. Tip number six, wear a lot of stripes, checks, patterns and all. Don't hesitate and go for cords. You can carry off patterns amazingly. So you should wear a lot of patterns, a lot of prints on the lower also, on the top also. What not to wear? What not to wear are loose tops. If you wear loose tops, what is the purpose of having this? So I love wearing loose tops, but what I do with them is I wear loose tops and then I wear a very skinny jeans which is high waisted and just tuck it in. Job done. So that is how you style if you have an hourglass figure. So moving on to the fifth body shape, that is the inverted triangle, which means you have broader shoulders than your bottom side. So it's like, how do I create a triangle like this? Very, very difficult. Very difficult. So your highlights should be your shoulder and your arms. Just show them off. Oh my god, broad shoulders looks amazing. So for that, tip number one, you can wear a lot of pencil skirts, fitted skirts, jeans and everything just to highlight the bottom side and also create an illusion of them being in proportion with your shoulders. Tip number two, you don't need a lot of layering since you already have broad shoulders, great arms, so you don't need a lot of layering and ruffles and stuff. Tip number three, wear straight cut jeans. Straight cut jeans just makes your legs look longer and give proportion to your shoulder and your legs. Tip number four, wear a lot of v-neck shirts, v-neck t-shirts like the one I am wearing. It just gives your shoulder a sense of looking narrow. Since they are a little broader than your lower side, it just makes them proportional. It just makes them look proportional. It just shows your shoulder to be a little narrow. Now, what not to wear? You don't have to wear a lot of patterns, ruffles, stripes and stuff. Plain t-shirts, printed are the ones for you. You should always keep your top minimalistic. You can experiment with the bottoms as much as you want. Go for polka dots, stripes and stuff. Looks amazing. A plain white t-shirt with a straight cut jeans with some flower pattern or something. It looks amazing. I have one. This is from All About You. It just looks amazing. Something like this looks amazing. Imagine if you're wearing this under this. Looks amazing. So yeah, these were the body types that I know of. And whatever little knowledge I had about styling them, I've shared it with you guys. At the end, I just want you to know that whatever body shape you are, it depends on your height, your weight, your even your personality about how you like to wear things. So you should figure out on your own what suits you and what doesn't. Try things on. Don't hesitate from experimenting. As much as you experiment, you'll get to know more about your body type and what suits you and what doesn't. It's not necessary whatever I've told you wahi yahi acha lagega aur kuch acha nahi lag sakta. Sab acha lagta hai. I have an hourglass figure. I wear loose t-shirts at home with just shorts. That's my style at home. When I go out, that is the time I get dressed and I like to look good, so I've experimented a lot in the past few years. I am running out of breath. I can talk for 15-16 minutes straight. Never mind. So yeah, it is not necessary that it fits to the standard sizing that I've told you. You can have a totally different body shape also. And if you do, please do let me know so that I can create a style for it. Please, I don't. For you, I'm just saying it again. If you like it, wear it. It doesn't always mean you have to follow the thing. Zaruri nahi hai jo bataya gaya hai, wahi karna hai. Apni marzi pe, whatever you like, you can wear. So ye sab kuch I created on my own. Whatever I knew, jo mujhe pata tha, uske hisab se maine apni knowledge I've shared with you guys. And if you have any more information, you can share it with me in the comment section. Lastly, I would give only two tips. Tip number one, love your body the way it is. You don't need to look like a specific person. You go like, oh, she's so slim, she's so like that, I want to be like. You might, and you just have to work for it. But if you can't, you already are beautiful as the way you are. You don't need to change. One. Number two, don't listen to anybody. Even if you're watching the video till now, whatever I have said, wo meri knowledge I'm sharing with you. But you can wear what you like. Wear what you like. If you want to style them, I can definitely help you in styling them, but I can't tell you what to wear. Another tip that I have, which is like an extra tip I'm giving, one is if you are a curvy girl, wear thick stripes. They just look amazing. And if you आप petite should wear thinner and vertical stripes. It just looks nice. Tip number 2 is about vertical stripes. If you want to look a little taller, you should wear vertical stripes. It just gives an illusion of you being taller. So these were my 2 extra tips for you. Just थोड़ा सा चोरी से डाल देंगे वीडियो एक्स्ट्रा. सो दिस वॉज द वीडियो अबाउट स्टाइलिंग. डन. इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन प्लीज लीव एनी रिकमेंडेशन इफ यू हैव कि आगे क्या देखना चाहते हैं आप लोग. जस्ट लेट मी नो इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन. फॉलो मी ऑन इंस्टाग्राम इफ यू हैवंट ऑलरेडी. माई आई डी इज इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. द टॉप आई एम वेयरिंग इज फ्रॉम शीन. बिफोर यू गाइज आस्क्ड बहुत सारे लोगों ने पूछा इन माई पास्ट वीडियोज कि कहाँ के टॉप्स पहने मैंने, कि मेरा आउटफिट कहाँ का था. सो आई एम जस्ट गोना मेंशन एवरी टाइम व्हाट एम आई वेयरिंग. आई एम वेयरिंग अ टॉप फ्रॉम शीइन. दिस फ्रॉम शीइन. आई विल लिंक इट डाउन बिलो. ऑल द क्लोथ्स आई हैव शोन आई विल लिंक देम डाउन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन सो यू कैन सी. सो वी आर डन. आई विल सी यू गाइज नेक्स्ट टाइम विथ येट अनदर वीडियो. टिल देन अगर वीडियो अच्छा लगा तो प्रेस द लाइक बटन. अगर बहुत अच्छा लगा तो शेयर इट विद योर फ्रेंड्स फैमिली ऑन व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप. स्पेशली शो इट टू योर मदर्स. आई थिंक दुनिया की सारी माओं को हम बहुत अच्छे लगते हैं. तो आई थिंक यू कैन शो इट टू योर मॉम. थैंक यू. सो या डू शेयर इट विद योर फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली. डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल टू सी मोर वीडियोज इन फ्यूचर. टिल देन साइनिंग ऑफ.